All right, and it's time to dish with Miss Melanie Dishman. How are you doing today?
I'm good.
And I know you just got out of the movies, like literally.
I did. I drove straight over here. I saw World War Z and thumbs up.
Okay.
I have to tell you, I was really surprised. It's good.
So we know that it's kind of got the zombie theme behind it, but would you say it's really intense? They do a good spin on it?
I think so. You know, this is one of those movies from they balance the scope of the action. You know, so you've got these, I think everybody's seen the trailer just about, that where the zombies are making a human ladder, you know, going over a wall. Well, they balance that very, very nicely against just this one-on-one, you know, with Brad Pitt and you know, some of these, he plays a UN, someone who used to work for the UN who was out in the field, and he's called back when this virus or whatever it is, they never really fully understand what it is, breaks out worldwide, and, you know, creating the situation with these zombies.
Okay.
And so it's, you know, when you hear the word zombie, you immediately think, I don't know, I just think a cheesy horror film. Mm-hmm. This is not true. It's very intense, and you know, he moves around the globe, Jerusalem, Newark, you know, stateside, and then he goes to Jerusalem, then he goes to England, and, you know, back around in South Korea. So he's constantly moving, trying to figure out what's causing this before it just kills the entire human race. And so, you know, I really was at one point sitting on the edge of my seat. I really thought it was very surprising. There's been a lot of trouble with this movie, a lot of you know, they reshot a lot of it. They're over budget. They pushed the opening back.
Mm-hmm.
And none of that is good for a movie, but this would be the exception to that.
And I had seen an interview from Brad Pitt, kind of, I guess, defending that, mm-hmm. saying, well, if you work so hard on something, you want it to be really good.
Yeah, and I think, you know, I trust him in that because he does, you know, he knows a lot about filmmaking. This is not a vanity picture, although he's in almost every scene. And but he is not. This is not a star-driven film. It's
okay.
It's a very. It's a top. You know, it's a subject-driven film,
great.
And it's really, really good.
Good. And what about Much Ado About Nothing? Kind of switching gears here.
You know, I don't want anyone to get their hopes up. This movie did not open here, but it's over at River Oaks in Houston, and this could be one of the nicest little treats of summer. It's, you know, Josh Whedon, who's not known for this kind of thing. This is a vanity picture. This is what you get to do when you make a lot of money and you're successful. You say, I want to go to my neighbor's backyard, or it's either his house or a friend of his, and I want to get all my closest friends together, and we're going to do a modern take on a Shakespeare, a classic Shakespeare play, and that's basically what this is.
Wow. Okay.
And to top it off, I just think I'm going to film it in black and white, and I'm just going to put it out there and see what happens. And I think it will probably do very well for a small little niche film, and you know, but you'll have to go to Houston to see it. I do not think it will come here.
What about Monsters University? We're
excited about
this.
Well, I talked to somebody last night you could see this movie last night. And I talked to someone who just got out of it, and they said it was really cute. You know, they'd seen the others. And so it's in keeping with that, you know, that Billy Crystal and John Goodman, all the voices are back. And, you know, I haven't seen it, but the word is it's very good. And so there were a lot of families at the theater today that were not seeing zombies. They were seeing monsters.
Well, there you go. Fair enough. Good for them there as well. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Melanie. We appreciate that. Stay with us. We'll be right back.